in this video, we're gonna build the entire thing from scratch so you can see how it's all worked together. Now, the initial blast is the message that we send out to the first bunch of people. And the second one is what we call a nurturing reply yes workflow. And this is what it looked like. As you can see here, it's more linear, it's more simple. It's pretty much wait for the first people to say yes, and then we'll just put them onto the sequence where they get SMS, wait, and SMS. And the content of the SMS is just giving them link to book appointment or access to the offer of the first workflow. Now let's build everything from scratch so you can see how to link everything together and how simple it really is. So you want to log in to your high-level account, head over to automation and click create workflow and start from scratch. And the first thing I do is that I want to name my workflow properly. I want to write SMS marketing initial blast demo. And then I want to click save. All right, so the first step that I want to start with this workflow is a SMS. I want to head over to this plus icon here and click plus and type the word SMS. Now, the first thing that you can see here is send SMS. Now, don't worry about this manual action to SMS here. It's a totally different action and that's for another video. You want to click send SMS and then you want to type the content in here. Keep in mind, if you head over to this tag icon, there's a lot of custom field and custom value that you can use. Now, luckily for you guys, I'm gonna give you our script for real estate agents. It say, hey, contact first name is username from location. I'll be around your area tomorrow all day. Would you like a quick home appraisal update where we can show you how to add 50K plus in value to your current property? P.S. reply yes to this message and we'll be in touch. Now, this worked really well with real estate agent because people would think that real estate agent is nearby, which they are, and then it really just make it easy for people to reply yes. Now, that's worked really well for our real estate agent industry. If you're in the dentist or home improvement, you really just have to craft a message that work for your industry. So I'm gonna copy this and I'm gonna paste it here. All right. And obviously, once you send it, this bracket is gonna convert into an actual value. That means it's gonna say, hey, John, instead of hey, contact first name. And then you wanna hit save, all right? Before we move on to the next step, we want to name this action properly. So we want to name SMS Blast. Actually, we're right. Initial SMS Blast, right? And this would be helpful for you to recognize what SMS it is. Right, and the next step is to head over to this plus icon again and search wait, and we want to select this wait action. As you can see here, this wait action have a lot of options, but the one that we look for here is contact reply, and we want to select reply to initial SMS blast. This is why it's very important to name your action properly, okay? And this one we're gonna name wait for reply, okay? Capital reply, and then you want to select a timeout. Okay, now if you don't know, the timeout feature is very useful for contact reply. You can set a certain timeout period that instruct the automation to wait for the lead to reply. So what that means in our case, if the lead don't reply in 1 day, which is the timeout period, they will move on to the next steps. So it's very important that you set a timeout for any wait action that is waiting for a reply. Okay, and you want to save action. Okay, now the next action we want to take is condition, right? We're gonna write IF, if or else, right? And in that condition, we're gonna hit over select here and we're gonna select contact reply. And the first option we're gonna give them is false. So that means when contact don't reply, right? And we're gonna name this branch no reply. You want to add the next condition, you want to add a branch here, right? And this one is what we call reply yes, okay? So when someone reply yes, you want to hit reply message, contain yes. The reason why we put contain instead of is because someone might reply yes please, yes I want, or something along with yes. So contain is properly a safer way to do that. So now we have two conditions, which is when people don't reply or people who reply yes, right? And we're gonna hit save. Now you can see here there's two branches that you can build steps and workflow underneath them. And as you can see here, the last branch is auto created. It's called none. Now, what that means is that if the condition does not match any of these two, what that means, guys, if the system pick anyone who does not match these two conditions, they will fall out to the non-condition, all right? So let's break it out logically. If people do reply and people do reply anything then yes, then they would fall on here, right? Technically. So this is people who reply, who are you? How much is it? Where is this? Who is this? To make it easier, we'll want to come here and name this condition, people who reply something else. That would make it easier for you to understand in this tutorial. Now, what we need to do next is to build workflow and action with these three conditions. When people reply yes, I typically like to tag them and I would give them a very unique tag such as reply yes, so that we know this lead are hot. And I would click here, create new tag, save the action. And the next thing that I want to do is I want to add them into the workflow. I would write workflow and we're going to add them to the second workflow. Remember, we have the nurturing reply yes, but we're going to build that together soon, but we're going to add them to our existing workflow and we're going to name it add to reply yes workflow. Obviously, if you're doing this for your business or your client, you can be creative. You can add so much more action because you know that these people reply yes, but we just want to keep this tutorial very simple for now. Okay. And we want to hit save. Okay. Now let's move on to the people who actually reply, but they reply with something else. I personally would give them a different tag, right? But you can give them the same tags, obviously. You can give them one universal tag, but I like to give them a reply something else to SMS campaign. Yeah, just give them this very long tag and then I would hit save again. Again, guys, if you're building this for yourself or your client, you can add so many things. And the next step, guys, we want to select opportunity. We want to create opportunity for this guy. And again, we just select any pipeline stage and pipeline for now. Doesn't really matter. To remind me, we should be adding opportunity to this also, right? So you want to add tag. Sorry, I meant to copy them, right? Do you want to create opportunity? I like to add note, right? Add contact note. I say this contact reply to SMS last campaign on, right? So I would say on the note, you can see what date they reply on. You can backlog it right now. I normally go to right now and go to date last. Okay, again, you can just copy this, copy action, and move it to here. I normally have it quite the same, but with the only difference is that the yes part, they will go to the yes workflow. This one, you just have to manually reply to them because we don't know what question would come up. And the next thing I want to do, guys, is to give them a score, all right? What we call modify contact engagement score. Now, this is a new feature. Obviously, someone who replies something else, I'm not going to give them higher score than someone who replied yes. So I would give this guy like a 5, right? And I want to copy this action again. And this is so fast because you could just copy and paste this stuff, right? And with this one, I want to give them a 10. And I want to here plus 10 in my name. And while this one, I can have like plus 5. So if someone replied, they still reply. So we're going to give them plus 10 to plus 5. So we just finished two branch and two scenario here. So first is when someone reply yes, and when someone replies something else, right? A lot of it is the same as you can probably see. Now let's build automation for someone who don't reply, okay? Now what I like to do is I want to add a SMS again, but this time it's a follow-up SMS. I like to say contact first name. Are you there? Very simple, right? I don't go fancy with the whole paragraph follow-up thing. That's just not me. I would recommend using something light to follow up. This work like most of the time, are you there? And then we want to go to the wait step and we're gonna select waiting for a reply and reply to SMS, right? Again, like this is why you need to name it. So I'm gonna rename it and we're gonna wait for one day. If they don't reply, they move on to the next steps, right? So we're gonna hit save. So we're gonna name our action properly, SMS follow up one, save. You can see here, this changed to SMS follow up one because this wait is specifically waiting for this SMS. It's not waiting for anything else, it's waiting for this SMS. Now after that, we're just going to the condition again, if and else, right? And this time we're gonna select a different condition, right? We're going to select contact reply still. Contact reply is true. So if they reply anything at all, right? They would go to, well, I like to keep it simple. Technically you can do three branch, but really I'm just doing two branch here. They can go to here, right? So if they reply from, are you there? Any reply at all, they would come here. I like to keep it simple. Technically you should make three branch like this, reply yes and reply something else, but that would make the entire tutorial very complex and I do not recommend that. If they reply at all, they would just come here. So the next condition is that if they don't reply to the second message, are you there? Right, we're gonna take the easy way. We're gonna copy everything from here, copy all action from here, copy from here, and boom, you can see here half of the automation is already done. We need to change this SMS though. So this is what we call SMS follow up two. And if someone don't reply, are you there? I normally just say, right. But this time don't even mention their name at all. Just say dot, dot, dot. That's normally work for us. So same thing, it will wait for one day. If they reply, they will go to the reply yes, right? If they don't reply, you can really just keep doing this. You can go copy, copy all and copy here, right? And you change this to SMS reply three and just change this message to something else. Like, did I make you mad? I don't know. We don't really go for that long and I don't recommend you keep follow up for that long. It's just wasting money at this time. If people don't reply, probably not gonna reply on the third one. One of the things that you need to be mindful about is that you need to make sure that the wait step is responsible for wait for SMS follow-up two, okay? And the wait step for this one is responsible for SMS follow-up three, right? So very important that you get this one correct. And guys, that's pretty much our initial blast workflow built completely from scratch. And you can see here, we stop here. So if they don't reply on the third SMS follow-up, there's nothing to do. Like, we just leave them alone. Okay, I would recommend go as far as SMS 2 or 3. I would not recommend going to SMS 4. But again, you can go as far as possible and keep follow up with them until they do reply, technically. So now let's just come back to the dashboard. This is the initial blast demo that we built from scratch. We want to create a second workflow. Again, create workflow, start from scratch. And the first thing we do is we want to name our workflow correctly. I'm going to say SMS marketing and nurturing reply. Now, the goal of this workflow is to nurture people that say yes, okay? So it's very simple. All we have is just SMS and we're gonna put our message here. Great. Here is our booking link, right? It's given that, you know, you want people to book. If you want people to buy, just put your purchase link here or your website link, and you want to go to user and calendar link. Now, if you don't want to overcomplicating this, you could just type out like your URL, mybooking.com, right? You don't have to use the custom field or custom value at this stage, right? And you can add some message saying like, let me know once you have booked so I can send you all the bonus. That's normally work really well for our business. So yeah, at this part, just have either one or other. Don't have like the actual URL and the actual custom field. That would be very conflicting, right? And then you want to hit save and you want to hit wait. And then we want to be waiting for time delay at this time. We're just waiting for time, right? Waiting for a day. And then we want to send them a reminder to see if they take action or not, right? So this is why we have two separate workflow, because in this workflow, we're gonna have stop on respond on, okay? Stop on respond is gonna be on, meaning that if they reply, we will stop texting them, very important that you understand this. That's why we can't have the whole thing in one workflow. And you want to save it. So let's go back to the builder. So I like to be lazy. I would go in here and I click copy, copy all action from here, and I would get all of that, right? Like, you would want to name your stuff properly, like wait one day, right? So when you copy, the actual name comes through. In the second message, what I like to do is just like give them a reminder. I would say something like, contact first name, does the link work? You able to book? Fine. And I would drop them the link again. But again, you can put your direct URL there, but I'm just gonna put the custom field for the demo. Okay, you wanna hit save and click save again. So right now we have two SMS follow-up to get them to take action. All right, I'm gonna be naming this properly so I don't have to repeat it. Save. And then what you want is, again, we can repeat this step, copy action from here. And the third one, again, you guys need to understand that if they reply on the first or second message, they would not get this third message. We're just writing it as a follow-up, okay? You wanna keep in mind that whoever reading this haven't responded yet. I could just be repetitive here. I can say, are you there? Contact first name. I would not even use contact first name at this stage because we've been using it quite a lot. Are you there? Dot. And yeah, I would just leave it as that. So we have three SMS follow-up to get them to take action, right? This campaign, this workflow is to get them to click on the link to take action, while the other workflow is to get them to reply. So this is it. This is the full tutorial building the entire workflow from scratch. And look, guys, just keep your eye on the price. The math is there. We've been doing it and we've been helping real estate agents make a lot of money from it. So that's why it only makes sense that we as a person or organization make money from it as well, from setting this automation and workflow up. Now, if you have any question, make sure that you drop in the comment. The link to everything that you see in this video is in the description, so make sure that you check it out. And if you like this video, consider giving it a thumbs up and share it with your agency friend. Otherwise, I'll see you on the next one. Hey guys, if you enjoy watching the video, make sure that you also checking out this content right there.